Hi, this is Monique, and today I'm going to show you how to use GIMP so that you can shrink and make fat pictures. So we're going to be using GIMP kind of like Photoshop. GIMP is a free software that's for photo manipulation, and it's basically almost exactly like Photoshop. So let's get to it. So right now I'm just opening GIMP. And what you want to do is you want to go to filters and then distort, and I think it's eye warp. So I'm just showing you where to go first, but I'm going to open a picture, and I have two pictures that I'm going to show you how to use. So we're going to use a picture of this lady sunbathing, and we're just going to go to filters, and we're going to make her upper body look bigger and her thighs look bigger. So right now, that's the tool I'm using. It's an airbrush tool. I'm going to go up to filters. There. And I'm going to go to distort and eye warp. So here you can see a preview of the picture. And you can see you can go to shrink or grow. You can move things and so on. Those are what I'm going to select. So I'm just going to make the radius a little bit smaller. And right now I'm going to go to grow, and I'm just going to move the cursor over the part I want to grow slowly. So we're just growing the chest area out. I might speed this up a little bit, but I also want to show you the before and after. And I want to show you how to grow her thigh area out, because her legs look really, really skinny here. So we're just going to grow the thigh area a little bit. As easy as that. So I'm going to do that to her hips a little bit, and then I'm going to show you how to shrink it. And the only thing we're going to do to shrink it is we're going to move, we're going to click on shrink instead of grow. And you know, if there are a couple imperfections, you can click on move and you can move them in or you can move them out. So I'm gonna hit shrink, and I'm gonna go and kind of undo what I did. I'm gonna shrink the chest area down a little bit more. And then once the preview is done, you're gonna be able to see the difference between the preview and the original picture. Okay. As you can see, it changed the picture really drastically. Okay, so I have a second picture here of a lady's face, and we're gonna basically do the same thing. We're gonna grow it or we're gonna shrink it. So I'm gonna go to filters, distort, and then eye warp. Okay. So I'm going to do the same thing. Right now it's on shrink, so it might distort it a little bit because she's got really sharp cheekbones, but we're just going to shrink it a little bit. You can see it more on the side of where her hair is reaching her face, but it looks like she hasn't eaten in 1,000 years and I do that so much, so I'm going to stop that. Maybe I'll work on her chin and her lips, make her lips a little bit smaller. Yeah, it kind of warps her lips a little bit, so. But I just want to show you that's how easy it is. Just moving the cursor over, changing the radius, and you can completely change somebody's face. Okay, so that looks kind of scary, so we'll just hit cancel. Yeah, that's the original picture. So we should just cancel it or try to regrow it a little bit. I don't know if I can make it look like the original picture again. I'll try, but I don't think I can. I can make her cheeks and her lips go back, but it looks a little off. It's the eyes that look a little bit off, so I'm just going to cancel it and then go back to the original picture. Let's go back to filters and go to distort and then eye warp. Okay. And maybe I'll just do it with a smaller radius, or I don't know. Let's shrink it down a little bit just so you can see the difference. Like if I do the nose,
change her eyes a little bit. Maybe only her cheekbones a little bit. Just enough to show you that you can change it into a little bit of a different picture and makes it look like a different person. If I wanted to, I could go in, I could change the lip color as well, and I could change her skin color, and she would look like a completely different person. Let's press OK. And you can see the difference that just made. Okay, so this video has been about how to use GIMP or Photoshop to distort an image to make it skinnier or fatter. Okay, thanks guys, bye. We'll be right back.